Communist China hid their outbreak from the world, silenced their doctors, shut down investigations, and blamed America.
This is no time for Donald Trump's record of hysteria, xenophobia.
Labeling COVID-19 a foreign virus.
The Biden plan will protect China.
Banning all travel will not stop it.
Joe Biden has defended China for four decades.
What a beautiful history we wrote together.
To stop China, you have to stop Joe Biden. America First Action is responsible for the contents of this advertising.
Seeing that ad exclusively here for the first time, and it was produced by pro-Trump super PAC America First Action. It's going to run in Michigan, Wisconsin, and Pennsylvania over the weekend. They also recently commissioned a survey showing a desire to reduce the U.S. dependency on China.
According to that survey, 78% of voters support policies to increase the United States' manufacturing capacity and reduce economic reliance on China. This matches some other national polling conducted since the pandemic began that we have covered here. America First Action's Communications Director Kelly Sadler joins us now via Skype to discuss. Thanks for being with us, Kelly.
Thanks for having me. Mm-hmm.
All right, tell us about the thinking behind this ad.
Well, Americans' distrust for China is at an all-time high. A recent Gallup poll came out where 57% of respondents had distrust in China in 2019. Now 67% of those do. And this is a bipartisan issue. Both Republicans and Democrats agree that we need to bring our supply chain, especially when it comes to national security items like medical equipment and pharmaceuticals, back to the United States. And Joe Biden has a 40-plus year of history of supporting globalism and outsourcing to China.
And Kelly, one of the things that we covered your ads previously here on the show and the amount of serious money that's being spent. Can you tell us about the ad budget behind these ads? And why is it that China in particular is the focus of these ads in these critical swing states that the president won last time?
Well, we've committed to a $10 million ad buy in Pennsylvania, Michigan, and Wisconsin that will run until the end of May, and then we'll reevaluate for a second tranche of spending. We've also reserved $26.6 million in the states of Florida and North Carolina. But in terms of the Rust Belt states, we saw 1.5 million jobs lost in this country, especially in those areas that were directly the result of Chinese outsourcing. Those jobs went from the United States to China. And now we're seeing the global repercussions of this. Joe Biden has been a globalist. He has had he voted for the WTO entry for permanent trade relations, saying that a rising China would benefit all of us, hoping that the Chinese government, the communist Chinese government, would democratize. That has not happened. President Trump will put Americans first, Americans workers first, and is working on looking at how to hold China accountable, as well as bring these manufacturers back to the U.S.
And yet, Kelly, at the beginning of this crisis, which happened to be timed when the president was trying to conclude, you know, some kind of a trade deal with China, he had favorable words for President Xi. Also, we've been reporting here about how he's dragging his feet on a Buy American order that would help to bring back some of those critical supply lines from China. So doesn't he have his own vulnerabilities here?
Well, there's a push and pull relationship with China, and we don't want our supply chain to be further damaged, especially in this coronavirus where we need these supplies and China has been hoarding them. However, I think the president yesterday has said that we are going to look at different ways to hold China accountable, and especially if China hid the fact that this virus originated or came out of the Wuhan laboratory. We're going to get to the origins of this story, and then things could be imposed like tariffs, lifting sovereign immunity so that individuals can sue China. And there's a bunch of different policy approaches that are on the table, some brought by senators Cotton, Josh Hawley, as well as Martha Blackburn.
Yeah, and Kelly, I think you're right about the polling. I mean, we've covered it here as well, so I understand why you're fixated on this issue. It also, though, frankly, seems like blame shifting. I mean, ultimately, the president is the president. He delayed in terms of response, had been briefed on the potential of this pandemic reaching our shores, didn't gear up in terms of ventilators and those critical supplies, and the death toll is what it is, in part because of his slow reaction, not only because of China.
This, there was some faults at the beginning of the administration in ramping up, you know, the ventilators and the masks and the PPE. But I think we're at a point in testing that we're feeling good. However, China did start. This was the origins of this virus. And they teamed up with the WHO, who is their PR firm, really, in lying to the world about the spread of this virus, the human-to-human spread of this virus, and the hazards of it. And the president was criticized very much so in the beginning in January when he put forth this travel ban, which ultimately did save lives.
Yeah, well, that's couldn't agree with you more on that one, Kelly. Thank you for joining us. We really appreciate you sharing that ad as well.
Thank you, Kelly.
Thank you, guys. Mm-hmm.
Next on Rising, Oscar-nominated filmmaker Josh Fox. He explains why he's been such a vocal critic of this new environmental documentary, Planet of the Humans, which we featured on the show by Michael Moore. That's next.